Welcome back to Let's Play Skyward Sword. In the last episode, we came into this water cave area, and we're looking for the water dragon. And in this episode, we're gonna find the water dragon. These guys are here. They're annoying as usual. And yep, we're gonna have another unnecessary text box, but that's fine. In this room is actually a goddess cube, which, like, in the last episode, I was like, oh, I think there's something in here we're missing, and, yeah, there's a goddess cube over here. It's over this little coral bridge. I don't know if you can actually see this from the angle we were at, like, from the save point, but, yeah, we're just gonna activate this. We'll get it later, like, in a few episodes. There's no reason to, rush. I mean, if we activated, like, a whole bunch of goddess cubes, I would be like, oh, let's go get them all, but it's just, like, one, so it's fine. We're just gonna ignore it. And we're going to continue following this guy because he knows all about the things. He's like friends with the water dragon, or I guess a servant of the water dragon, because the water dragon is like a queen, so it makes sense. And we got another gate. Let's not fail. I failed this a few times before. That one is actually, that gate is a little bit shorter than the one we've jumped over last time, but here we have a mini-boss. This guy's really afraid. Oh, they're back. It's one of the fish the weirdo brought in here. Alright. Yeah, he's like, they're as mean as they come, but it's actually very weak. Even though it's a mini-boss, it's pretty weak. You just have to get him angry. He's gonna, like, swim into you, and, oh, I did it wrong. That's weird. It's the first time I've ever done it wrong. He's gonna... Did he do it this time? I can't tell. I have to turn around. Yeah, if he knocks his head into something and he gets dizzy, you just have to hit him one time. Like, he dies in one hit. You just have to stun him, hit him once, and he's just done for. So, yeah, the water dragon is in the next room, which is great. So we don't have to, swim around too much longer. There's, also in the next room, where the water dragon is, there's, like, a ton of treasures. We're gonna get some good stuff in there. But we're probably going to talk to the water dragon first. She has a lot of dialogue, by the way, and I'm not going to read all of it because there's just so much dialogue and we don't want to take forever, and I'm just going to mess up so badly if I tried to read all of it. By the way, this guy's head is a key. Like, that's his purpose in life. He exists to be like a living key to this one door. That must be a sad existence. I mean, maybe he has other purposes, but that seems to be his main purpose. Or maybe that's just his hat. Maybe we can just assume it's just his hat. I don't know. I'm getting into some random territory here of just talking about random nonsense. But yeah, we get into this room. This is like the throne room, I guess. And the water dragon's up there. Let's see. Sometimes there's like amber relics that just spawn all over this place. I don't see any right now, so we're just gonna go ahead and talk to her. She's like, you there, human, I told you I'm Hylian. Why don't you people know the difference? Alright, so she's like, oh, how'd you get in here? This is a sacred place. Yeah, we're looking for the water dragon. You know, Link, I'm pretty sure that's the water dragon. Those with manners address me as Farron. I thought you were like the water dragon. I don't know. Can't we just call you like queen something? I don't know. I keep saying I don't know. But she's a servant of the goddess. We're the chosen hero. So let's get along. You have the sacred flame, right? She's like, oh, you have one of my scales. Yep, it's a special gift you gave to someone, and then I acquired it somehow. I forgot how we even... Oh yeah, we got the scale because we did the special trial, so. And yeah, that Kikui, he told us where you were. Actually, he hinted at where you were, but didn't exactly tell us. And she wants to eat him now. Well, he's quite far away. I doubt you could actually get to him. Come here seeking the sacred flame. Of course we have. That's our whole purpose, is to strengthen the sword. Shrimpy boy like you hardly looks like part of the goddess's chosen hero. Get it, shrimpy? Because water? Yeah. Yeah, a test is in order to prove everything you say. Okay. So she's gonna give us a test. She's like, oh, Garahim was here, and, he wounded her. So, Right now, she's in this basin of sacred water, and she's going to explain now that the healing properties have diminished, and she needs some more water, which means we have to do a fetch quest. It's not quite a fetch quest, but you got it. We'll get you some more special water for you to heal, and then she'll help us out with getting the flame. Yeah, and we can douse for the water, but I know where it is. Don't worry, Fee, I'm on top of this. So, believe it or not, the water is in a place where some people are like, oh, that's terrible. And I'm like, oh, that's really cool. But yeah, we're gonna go looking for that water soon. She explains, yeah, if we continue to that door behind her, it leads out to the woods. So yeah. Yes, Fee, I know about dousing. You don't have to explain it. But yeah, let's get some treasures in here. There's some good stuff in here. Jump out there. Where is the chest? It's way over here. Since there's not too much to talk about, since we're just excuse me, Fee. There we go. Yeah, I would like to announce, maybe. I have a new Let's Play coming out on Friday. I hope you guys will like it. It's, I don't know if I want to keep it a secret and let you guys find out for yourself or just tell you now. Because, like, these videos only get, like, a few views each, so not a lot of people will be spoiled. I'm going to tell you what it is right now. It's Katamari Damacy, like I promised a long time ago that I would do. Okay, now that I'm done spoiling that, I don't know. Most of you probably don't care. Yeah, there's one more treasure. But, that Let's Play is gonna be great. What I did was I recorded so far ahead that no matter how busy my life gets, it's always gonna come out on time. Unlike this Let's Play, which occasionally doesn't come out on time. Like, this is gonna come out on Wednesday because I was super busy the day before. I had to work extra that day. So, yeah. Let's, see what's in this treasure chest. It's... Aw, man, really? Really, you're gonna do that to me, game? You're really gonna do that? Okay, when I was practicing earlier, this was an evil crystal, which are really rare and really important to get a whole bunch of, and the game's just like, nah, you don't need one of those. Yes, I do, game. Why would you do this? Yeah, that's, it's unfortunate that we got one of those. Those are, like, semi-rare, so I mean... I guess that's okay. Here we got one of those butterfly spots, so let's take care of this. Let's see what's going on here. What are we gonna get? Are you gonna give it to me? No. Just a monster claw. Nothing too important. It would have been great if they were like, ha, we tricked you. Here's the thing you wanted so badly. Also, there's another... Why is there, yeah, there's one over there. Whatever. We're just gonna activate this bird statue, and then, is there another thing here? Because I see butterflies around here. Is there? Maybe I'm just hallucinating. I don't know. We're actually gonna go up here to activate a shortcut, and then go back to the bird statue. So, Link's like, oh man, look, it's a forest that I've been to before. You don't have to act so surprised, Link. Yeah, she has more information, blah blah blah. Nothing that I can't explain. Yeah, we're just gonna back out of there. I don't even know what she was talking about because I don't care. So yeah, we're just gonna push this over and create a shortcut and then go back to the sky to get to where we really want to go, which is actually the first temple in the game. That's right. The water we need to continue in the story is in the first temple of the game. Which I think is really cool, reusing the dungeon, but in a different way. I was like, that's pretty cool, because it's like the dungeon's done, but then you go back and it's like different. But other people are like, oh, that's just lazy, but I thought it was cool. It's not like they do that all the time. It's like a pretty unique thing to this game, unless it was in Twilight Princess, which, again, that's the only Zelda game I haven't played. So maybe they did it there too, but I doubt it. I haven't heard of such a thing. So, yeah, this is the fastest way to get there. Because if you remember, there's all this like platforming and like you have to go across the ropes and stuff, and I don't want to bother with that. We're just gonna warp there. You know, if there was ever like an HD remake of this game, I think it would be a really good idea if you were like in the same area, you could warp from one bird statue to the other without having to go to the sky first. I think that would just be a nifty idea, I think. You know, there's a whole bunch of stuff you could probably improve on with an HD remake, including making the controls a little bit more precise. I've already said that I like the motion controls because they work fine, but you know, if you made them work a little bit more precisely, that would be pretty cool. I know that the motion controls in Nintendo Land are actually a lot more precise. And yeah, if he's like, oh, you have to make it all the way to the end of the dungeon if you want to get that water, that's fine, V. I probably already knew that because there was that like waterfall thing at the end. Let's see, how long have we been recording for? 11 minutes. We can go a little bit longer. I'm going to run around you. Yeah, we're just gonna... From now on, I'm pretty much just gonna ignore those. They don't do anything too special. Just gonna cut down that. And what else do we have here? We're gonna dig. Yep, got some roops. And is that supposed to disappear? Huh. But yeah, we can play this here because it's important. Said it's important. There we go. Yeah, it took a second. This guy pops out from the thing that we just got rid of somehow. He's like, oh, you're that guy from the volcano. Yep, that's me. It's like, here to do some treasure hunting? Well, I suppose it's treasure hunting in a way. And we are going to look for treasures while we're here. It's like, I called it. You got treasure hunter written all over you. Yeah, big stone guy. Who's the big stone guy? Well, he's actually talking about the Goron, who is talking about stuff and things or whatever. But this part, from now on throughout the game, some of the butterfly spots will have like one of these where you can draw. Now, if you draw a Triforce, you get a bunch of fairies. Let's see if I can do this right. It has to be good. Like, if it's not good, the game is just like, yep. The game will just give you some hearts if you didn't draw the Triforce very well. Which is too bad, because I thought that Triforce looked alright. It looked not bad for how weird the controls are for drawing that. I would have preferred it if, you know, it was the other way. The way that you use the sensor bar instead of, like, the gyrometer? I forget what it's called. Anyways, I'm just ranting on at this point. So, thank you all for watching this episode of Skyward Sword. In the next episode, we're gonna do the first dungeon all over again. And it's gonna be different. There's like new keys and doors and little nooks and crannies we didn't discover beforehand. It's a pretty cool idea, I think. Maybe you don't think so. Anyways, see you guys next time.